This is part one of a two-part series on comprehensive neonatal care, the piglet perspective. In the following slides, we will review the main strategic areas to implement an extended and successful neonatal period care for both the piglets and the sows. From a piglet perspective, we want to reduce the birth-to-nurse interval and improve piglet vitality the first 24 hours after birth. There are four goals in active piglet monitoring. All goals are equally important to accomplish. In the next few slides, we will discuss the first goal, drying the piglet. What does active monitoring mean? It means to be present every 20 minutes for the sow and the piglet's well-being. The labor force is allocated by one technician per 20 sows farrowing, and make sure to support the busiest days of the week, especially the first 2 hours of the day. Active monitoring also includes recording each intervention. That means each time you visited and how you intervened with her, how many piglets were born alive, and how many mummies or stillborns she's had. Target the small and medium piglets in under 3 pounds at birth. Mark to identify them for the other employees to make sure that they keep a close eye on them. It's important to provide extra support when monitoring the first 2 hours of each day. You can do this by focusing on drying the at-risk piglets first thing in the morning. Newborn piglets' rectal temperature drops dramatically in the first 30 minutes after birth. Their temperature goes from 102 to below 93 degrees Fahrenheit. Focus on the small and medium piglets. Their access to colostrum will be more challenging. By doing this, you will shorten the birth-to-nurse interval, which will result in higher survivability rate. Reducing birth-to-nurse interval is key for survivability. After drying the piglet, place them on the udder to establish their first udder interaction. Beware that some piglets will need extra support in finding the udder. What is the udder interaction? The small, medium-sized piglets are the at-risk population. They will require extra attention to establish the suckling behavior. In the following slides, we will discuss the second goal in active monitoring, keeping the piglets warm. Follow the best practices for farrowing room setup. First, make sure you have proper room temperature. Second, proper microenvironment, which is between 95 to 98 degrees Fahrenheit. Avoid drafts and ensure all heat sources are working. Review piglet behavior at each observation every 20 minutes during monitoring for all the litters in the room, and adjust heat sources accordingly to how the piglets are behaving right away. It is very important first thing in the morning to identify all the piglets in need of attention. Dry them, place them under a heat lamp, then place them on the udder. Assist piglets that are disoriented inside the farrowing space that are active, but they are not nursing. In the following slides, we will discuss the third goal of active monitoring, keeping the piglet safe. By assisting the sows and the piglets, you are keeping them safe. This will increase the piglet's viability at birth and also reduce the number of stillborn piglets. Active monitoring means checking each sow every 20 minutes while the monitoring team is on duty. You can check the birth canal following your protocols if there is not a new piglet born after 30 minutes, the last piglet is born but completely dry, or there are presence of stillborns. do not forget, it's important to keep the creep area temperature in the correct range and the heat sources in working conditions. This is part of keeping the newborn piglets safe. Check the piglet behavior in the creep area and adjust the heat if you notice they are too cold or too hot. The fourth goal in active monitoring is making sure those piglets have full bellies. Here are some colostrum intake quick facts. First, the quicker the better. Second, as much as possible. And third, the small and medium piglets need at least 7 ounces of colostrum. By doing these things, you will lower the birth to nurse interval, which will lower the mortality. First thing in the morning, it is very important to identify and mark any empty belly piglets born overnight. Also, empty belly piglets that are vital and trying to nurse. And sleepy and empty belly piglets that are sleeping under the heat source. It's important to check every 20 minutes to make sure that the marked piglets are nursing comfortably without competition. Identify situations with udder competition. Small, medium piglets need to nurse without the competition. Split suckling management is an effective tool to reduce udder competition and to ensure those marked piglets get colostrum. Active monitoring every 20 minutes, first thing in the morning, is key for a world-class execution for any comprehensive neonatal care. From the piglet perspective, keeping them dry, warm, safe, and full bellies is a fundamental practice as a whole to increase their survivability. These are general recommendations, and we encourage the production staff to follow the farm protocols. Farms should have procedures created and approved by their production management head.